Welcome to ILLUXN. Today, we're gonna learn how to make freeze frame character intro in Premiere Pro. First, adjust your sequence settings to match your footage. These are the settings I'm using for this video. Import your footage into Premiere Pro and drag it onto the timeline. Move the playhead to the timecode where you want to freeze the frame. Press C to select Razor tool and cut the video layer. Right click and select Add Frame Hold. This will freeze the rest of the clip on a single frame. Move the playhead back about 1 second and cut the layer again. Press V and right click on the midsection and open Speed Duration. Set the speed between 200 to 300%. This adds a dynamic movement to our character before freezing into a pose. Join the layers. Hold Alt or Option key and drag the layer up to duplicate. Drag the duplicated layer up by 3 tracks, giving room for the upcoming elements. Go to Effect Controls. Select the Pen tool in the Opacity section. Draw a mask over the character's outline by clicking the left mouse button. Let's zoom in a bit for convenience. This mask will create a cutout of our character. I'm creating a rough mask due to time constraints. You can take your time to make a precise mask without trimming any edges. Close the mask by connecting start and end points. Set the zoom to fit, and this is how the mask should look upon completion. Set the mask feather to 0. Hide the bottom layer to see the mask shape clearly. Unhide the layer. Go to Effects and apply the following 4 effects in the exact same order. First, search for Gaussian Blur and drag it onto the character layer. Second, search for Luma Curve and apply it to the layer. Third, search Threshold and apply. And finally, search Tint and drag it onto the layer. Go to Effect Controls, scroll down to the Threshold effect. Expand the level option. Decrease the level closer to 0 based on your preference and your own image. If you aren't satisfied with the result, scroll up to Luma Curve and adjust the curve to achieve your desired look. Once you are satisfied, select the layer, go to Effect Controls, scroll down to Gaussian Blur, and set the blur to 5. This will smoothen the edges. Now, before moving on to the next step, choose a color theme for your image with 2 to 3 colors, one lighter and one darker. My color theme is pink and blue. Now, scroll down to the Tint effect and open the Map White color section. Select a light color for the white areas of the image. I'm selecting pink. Click OK. Open Map Black and select a dark color. I choose dark blue, which makes my theme pink and blue. Next, drag the grunge texture below our character layer on the timeline and adjust its length to match the other layers. Go to Effects and apply the tint effect to the grunge texture layer. Go to Effect Controls, scroll down to Tint, click the eyedropper icon next to Map Black color and click on the lighter color of your image. Then click the other eyedropper icon and select the darker color from the image. Let me just make the blue color a bit more dark to differentiate it from our character cutout. Next, drag the grunge banner below the character layer on the timeline and adjust its length. Select the banner layer and in Effect Controls, set rotation to -23. Increase the scale to 120 and adjust the position to move the banner downward. Adjust all these values according to your own image. Observe the technique I'm using to achieve certain effect instead of simply copying the numbers. Next, go to Effects, apply Tint to the banner layer. Open Effect Controls and open the black color section in Tint and select a color that complements your theme. I'm choosing dark violet. Open Effects and search for Drop Shadow and apply it to the banner. Go to Effect Controls, scroll down to the Drop Shadow effect, open the shadow color and choose a color that contrasts the banner color. I'm selecting dark pink. Select the type tool. Click on the image and type in your text. Drag the text layer below the character layer and adjust its length. Expand Text Properties. Choose a font you like. And increase the font size to 170. Make the text italic if you like and set letter spacing to 10. This just makes the text more stylish. Scroll down to Text Transform Properties. Set rotation to -23 and move it over the banner by adjusting the position. Scroll up and open Fill Color of the text. Choose a color that matches your theme. I'm choosing dark pink. Select both the text and banner layers, then right-click and create a nested sequence. Hide the nested sequence for a while. Now let's begin animating the objects. Select the grunge background layer, then choose the pen tool from opacity section. Set zoom to 50%. Draw a small mask in one corner of the background. The purpose of this mask is to create an unwrapping effect for the background. Set mask feather to 0. Click the mask path stopwatch. This creates the first keyframe. Press the right arrow key to skip forward one frame. Select the mask and expand it by dragging its points to reveal more of the background. This creates the second keyframe. Again, skip forward one frame. Drag the mask points to show more area of the background and it makes the third keyframe. Skip forward one frame. And for the fourth and final keyframe, cover the whole screen with the mask to reveal the background completely. Set the zoom to fit. Now, if you move the playhead frame by frame, the background appears to unwrap on the screen. Select the grunge background layer. Move playhead to the first keyframe. Right-click on the mask in opacity and copy it. Unhide the nested sequence. Select it. And right-click on opacity and paste the copied mask. This applies the mask to the nested sequence, including the four keyframes. Now, let's animate our character cutout. Move the playhead to the timecode where the background is fully revealed. Select the character layer. Click on Anchor Point property. Then move the anchor point almost to the bottom of the character cutout. This point acts as the center for rotation. Click on stopwatches of position, scale, and rotation to set the first keyframes. Move the playhead 3 seconds forward to set the second keyframes. Increase the scale to 105. Set rotation to 5 degrees. Change position values to move the bottom of the cutout off screen. Press space to play it once. Play it again to see how it looks. Now let's animate the banner and text. Select the nested sequence. Move playhead to 4th keyframe. Increase scale to 110. Set first position keyframe, then move playhead 3 seconds forward. Change position values to move the banner diagonally across the screen, and this creates the second keyframe. Play it once to see the result. And finally, animate the background. Move playhead to 4th keyframe, select background layer, increase scale to 110. Set first position keyframe and move the background to the right, keeping its edges off screen. Move playhead 3 seconds forward. Move the background to the left, creating the second keyframe. This animation moves the background in opposite direction to the banner, making it more dynamic. Play it again to see the result. And finally, add your favorite music and time the beat drop with the freeze frame effect, and you get this. And the final tip I can give you is, remember, it's not about just copying the values or the technique. It's about experimenting with what you've learned and adding your own unique spin on it and making it your own.